Hello everyone. So today we will be learning how to analyze earthquake resistant building. So when we are designing any earthquake resistant structure, we first need to analyze it. So we have two methods to analyze earthquake resistant building as per IS 1893 2002. So we will be using IS 1893 2002. To analyze an earthquake resistant structure. So for analysis, we have two methods. I will list it down here. One is static analysis. This is static analysis, which is also called as equivalent lateral force method. And the second one is dynamic analysis. So when a structure is subjected to no loads, or when the loads are very less, or if it is subjected to only dead load and live load, generally this type is adopted, that is static analysis. Or when the loads are very heavy, or if you want a more accurate method, in that case we need to go for dynamic analysis. In case of dynamic analysis, we have again different methods like response spectrum method, time history analysis and all. For the syllabus, we have only static analysis and response spectrum methods. So we will focus on only those two methods. So this is the problem we have. You can just write it down. Take a few minutes and write it down in your notebook. To save the time, I'm not writing it here. Okay. So now you can pause the video and write it down. Let us proceed. Now, the primary aim in doing the analysis of earthquake resistant structure is to find the base shear, and with the base shear we have to design the structure, that is to provide the steel and all. So to find the base shear, as per IS 1893 2002, the base shear is given by, I'll write it down here, these are the few basics which we require to solve the problem. So understand these basics. Base shear, which is denoted by VB, which is given by AH into W, where W is the total weight of the building, in kilonewton, and AH is horizontal acceleration coefficient. So as per IS 1893-2002, the value of AH is given by Z by 2 I by R SA by G. So we have this term, we have this term, and we have SA by G. So here Z refers to zone factor. So as we all know, our country is divided into four zones. Earlier it were five, but now it is four. So now it is it starts from zone 2, 3, 4 and 5. Zone 5 means high seismic area, whereas zone 2 means low seismic area. So now depending upon the structure which we are constructing, where it lies, value is given in IS 1893 for that zone. So like for example here you can have a look. So for zone 1 the value is 0.1 and the seismic intensity is very low, and for medium, that is for zone 3, it is 0.16, for zone 4 it is 0.24, and for zone 5 it is 0.36. So these values we need to take. Then next is I, which is importance factor. It is importance factor. Now depending upon the type of structure which you are constructing, we decide a value of importance factor. Say for example, if it's a general building, say for example, if it's a residential building, it has a value of 1. Or if in case, if you are constructing a hospital or a mall or a auditorium or a stadium wherein people more than 40 or more than 50 people sit together, in those cases we increase its value. That is, for residential buildings, say for residential buildings it is 1. For hospitals or malls, etc., or public buildings, we take it as 1.5. That means we are increasing the values of analysis by 50%. And next is R, that is called as response reduction factor. So it is response reduction factor. When we are constructing a structure using materials, the structure itself has some stiffness which it resists the load which is coming because of the earthquake. Now depending upon the material which we are using, the structure resists a small amount of force by itself. So these values have to be considered in the design so as to make the design economical. Now as per IS 1893, you can have a look over this. If it is a ordinary RC moment resisting frame, that is OMRF, the value we can take it as 3. If it is SMRF, that is special RC moment resisting frame, it is 5. If it is load bearing, that is unreinforced, the value we can take it as 1.5. Or if it is load bearing, that is reinforced with horizontal bands, we can take it as 2.5. Or if it is a shear wall, ordinary shear wall, we can take a 3. Or if it is a ductile RC shear wall, the value we can take it as 4. So the next term is SA by G, which is nothing but response acceleration coefficient. Response acceleration coefficient. So now depending upon what type of soil you are constructing the structure, we have certain values as given in IS 1893. You can have a look over it. So if it is a hard soil, for 5% damping, if it is hard soil, it is 1 plus 15 times TA. TA stands for natural period of the structure. It is in between 0 to 0.1 for hard soil. Similarly, for medium soil, we have different formulas given. And for soft soil as well, these values are for 5% damping, where TA is natural period of the structure, which is given here. You can have a look. For RCC frames without infill, it is 0.075 H raised to 0.75. फॉर स्टील फ्रेम्स विदाउट इनफिल इट इज 0.085 h = 0.75 एंड फॉर इनफील्ड फ्रेम्स द नेचुरल पीरियड इज गिवन बाय 0.09 h / d^0.5. सो दिस इज द टाइम पीरियड एंड टी ए इफ इट इज नॉट गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन यू कैन कैलकुलेट द नेचुरल पीरियड बाय द फॉर्मूला वी ऑल नो 2π/ω n और सिंपली इफ मास एंड स्टिफनेस आर गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन इट इज नथिंग बट ओमेगा इज फ्रीक्वेंसी इज नथिंग बट स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ m बाय के ओके बाय m एंड ऑल्सो इंस्टेड ऑफ यूजिंग दिस फॉर्मूला फॉर 5% डैम्पिंग इफ नेचुरल पीरियड इज नोन we can directly use this graph here which is given in IS-1893 for type 1 type 2 and type 3 soil that is rock medium or soft soil we can use this graph to calculate the value of SA/G okay so to revise it in brief this shear we need to find in the analysis the main aim of doing the analysis that is VB which is given by H into W where W is the total weight of the building, H is horizontal acceleration coefficient, Z is the zone factor depending upon where the structure is being constructed and its value lies in between 0.1 or 0.16 or 0.24 or 0.36. I is the importance factor for normal residential buildings. For normal residential buildings, it is 1 and for special buildings, it is 1.5. R is the response reduction factor. If you are using OMRF, it is, the value is 3, or if you are using special moment resisting frame, the value is 5. And SA/G is response acceleration coefficient. For 5% damping, the values are given. And for different percentage of damping, we can use these multiplication factors like here, which are given. So suppose for example if the damping is 7%, whatever value you get, that is whatever value you get for SA/G, you have to multiply it by 0.9. Or if the damping is 10%, you have to multiply it by 0.8. Fine.